caved in his breastplate. Probably shattered every rib he had.
The beloved bastard. Bugmydust 7891. Summary. One act of mercy can change a life, but two can change a world. Something that Robert didn't plan when he spared Lyanna's child, and Cersei didn't know when she didn't kill her king's beloved bastard. Notes. I don't own God. Warning. Presence of characters who are out of character, grammatical mistakes and possible super slow update. See the end of the work for more notes. Chapter 1. An act of mercy. Chapter text. Chapter. He was sticky with sweat and mad as he could possibly be. The pulsating need was almost stronger than him, and he knew that. He started a war, to save her, to return her, and now he was there. In all the summers of his life that passed, he never expected to stand above Arthur Dayne's body and listen to Lyanna's scream reaping his soul apart. As he was rushing with his men upstairs towards the tower with metal armor pressing his chest painfully, nothing mattered. But when he entered that room, he regretted it. He wished he died not knowing. The blood on the bed would be enough to tell its story, but the stench of death and Lyanna's fear as she was barely holding a child was breaking him. Robert Baratheon just stood frozen, and he wasn't alone. Don't. Please don't. Almost silent whimpering of once strong and proud voice he adored, a begging he never thought to hear. He didn't see the woman that was standing on the side, or how his men just turned around and left as they realized the situation. Ours is fury, the words said, and they expected him to raise his sword and do it. For he did it already. The Targaryen children bleed out on the expensive marble of Red Keep from being stabbed too many times and with their skulls crushed. Maybe Lannister's monster did it, but Robert celebrated their death and only gods would know how much he wanted it. She was beautiful, even now. As his very soul pained him in the realization that she picked Rhaegar and led the entire realm into a war over being his wife and bearing his children, only now to hold her babe in fear, to look at him like he's the monster. Please, don't. Don't kill him. A babe was a boy. A king of the Seven Kingdom of Westeros. The boy's very existence was a threat to him and his reign, and he wouldn't even have done much to change it. Babies die every day, especially if they are helped with it. He's my son. Ned's nephew. He's innocent. Quote. She mentioned Ned. Out of all the people she could mention, she mentioned a man who was more than his own brothers ever since they were John Arryn's good children. Robert loved Ned with equal ferocity as he loved Lyanna. And as Lyanna could barely hide the baby's face from him, he could see it. A Stark. That damn incest product maybe sired him, and there was nothing of his cousin in him. Why him? Brandon and your father are dead, the realm destroyed. I am so disgusting. Robert grabbed her and started to shake. Now weak from birth, she was barely able to hold her baby with very little strength she had had. Stop. Stop. You're harming John. She screamed desperately and he let her go like he was burned. John. A strong and good name. Name that would Ned like, the name he liked. In a different world maybe he would be his son, his legacy. Please. Don't kill him. Ned will look after him. He's a baby. As she was almost falling on his side, Robert grabbed her and the baby. His fingers were wet and sticky with blood, and some part of him finally realized. She was dying. As her head was on his chest, and her breathing getting slower and heavier, she repeated, "Don't kill him, please. Don't harm him. Promise me. Promise me. I promise." He would say anything at that moment. She betrayed him, and somehow he felt guilty. Somehow he still wanted to make her happy, and ease her pain. She smiled. And for a short moment, he was happy to make her happy, to have her smiling at him only for her to die. Like she was still alive and sleeping, Robert gently pushed her onto the bloody bed and closed her eyes. Not even fury was his, for that, he was too heartbroken. The babe, noticing commotion, started to whimper like it knew his mother passed away, but it was too powerless to do anything. Robert couldn't help himself. With his bloody finger, he followed the lines of his face tickling the baby's face. I hate you. Lyanna's betrayal still burns in his soul and he knew it would never stop, but the rage on the child diminished as he was looking at him. Maybe it was the seeing stark features on the baby, maybe it was weariness from the war, or seeing her death. Or maybe deep down some part of Robert saw the boy as the son he never will be. And as the child opened his eyes and when Robert Baratheon, the usurper, the rightful king of seven kingdoms saw Lyanna's eyes looking back at him, he knew that while he lost the love of his love, he gains a son. The wave of disgust was cracking through her skin. Her king, she thought sarcastically, brought a bastard. Like it wasn't enough all the shame he brought to her with drinking and whoring, some whore's child lived in a palace like he was a prince, like he was her son. Enjoyed the benefits of being king's brat, and yet out of all bastards he sired, that child was the only one Robert cared about. I will kill him, she sipped her wine and stared at the bastard's wet nurse. The poor girl had had enough brain to be ashamed, as she should have been, for raising it in her home. No, Cersei, you will not. He's just illegitimate, another of his bastards. He's amused until he gets bored, and Robert will get bored with a baby. Jaime made sense, especially if she births soon a child. After her wedding night, she couldn't bear having Robert on her, but her prince will be born. You killing a babe would culminate with Kingsguard taking off your head. I wouldn't get caught. She was the most beautiful of them all, a proud lioness to his lion. There was no greater perfection than his twin, but he would never allow her to discard her life for a bastard. He saw the baby, and as the entire kingdom, including Robert's own brothers, he was at first amused, then shocked at how Robert was dedicated to it. He had had children almost everywhere he went, and yet that boy was loved in a way never seen before. When he heard the stories of how the king approached the Red Keep with a baby boy in his arms, he was laughing, almost enjoying it. Robert was an embarrassment and a brute, and in some moments Jaime would enjoy nothing more than becoming a Kingslayer again, but the way he was with John brought a little bit of hope even to him. You will not look at the boy, you will not harm the boy. Tell me you understand, she said nothing. Her green eyes stared him down, looking with anguish and pride. She promised him nothing, said not a word, but until she births, a son kingdom needed, she wouldn't be safe. Lannister's legacy will not be safe, and that alone would be enough, but constant insulting was simply too much. The boy will die. Everybody knew where the boy was held. A beautiful nursery worthy of a prince, not a king's bastard, and yet Cersei knew that her children wouldn't get an inch of Robert's attention, but gods be damned if some other child would. Lions protect each other. She waited a night. Babies die all the time, and many die especially during the night. The gods give, and the gods take. That is how it is, especially when somebody helps them. Her ladies whispered how beautiful the nursery was, and they weren't wrong. It pained her to see just how many details Robert ensured personally for the bastard's nursery while he was barely able to keep himself sober. As Cersei silently walked across the room trying to be as quiet as she could possibly be, she was barely breathing. On one of the chairs, a pillow decorated with stags was lying down like a perfect weapon. Like the very destiny pick her to correct one of its mistakes. In the shiny crib there he was. A threat to her unborn children, a threat to Lannister's family. And he was holding a lion, and that made her stop and stare. Many words were said about the bastard. A son of a whore, a lady, a fisherman's wife, nobody knew the truth. What was known was that its name was a sign of respect Robert had towards Jon Arryn, one of the rare qualities he had. And King's Hand Jon Arryn, who once looked at her with ultimate disrespect and commented how dear departed Lyanna was a better choice, was delighted that a Robert named his illegitimate son after him, caring not that it was a bastard. He was seen carrying the babe and playing with him when Robert was pretending to rule the kingdom. The court laughed behind her back, mocked her, and talked about them, but nobody said how beautiful the boy was. Somehow she thought he would be bigger, stronger, more like her kingly husband, and somehow he wasn't. He looked like a prince. In his hands he was firmly holding a lion, a symbol of her house like it was his. Cersei could almost feel a smile on her face. She could almost imagine her father's facial expression if he ever saw something like that. Surprisingly, it didn't feel like an insult. She smiled finally when she saw a toy stag lying almost discarded on the boy's side. Good choice. Even John, the king's bastard, knew a lion was stronger. She felt an unknown urge to touch him, to hold him like he was hers. She didn't even realize she let the pillow fall on the floor as she took a sleeping baby in her arms. He didn't even wake up, as she put him on her chest. He felt so small and compliant, like a perfect little boy. His arms felt strong, almost like they were built for carrying a sword. Barely awake, he lifted his head from her chest and just looked at her with his sad gray eyes like he knows what will happen to him. The guilt chewed on her, crawling from the depths of her soul long forgotten. "What are you doing?" Angry whispers shocked her to the bone, but she didn't let go of the child even though it was pressed more fiercely to her chest. Jaime had kneeled easily ignoring the armor in which he was dressed. Most likely he was doing rounds, she realized. "I told you not to come close to the boy. Have you lost your mind? Robert will kill you if he finds you. Am I harming the bastard?" Cersei shook her head, showing Jaime the sleepy baby. Her twin finally looked at them only to see a dark-haired babe sleeping on her chest like she was his mother. "He's happy being where he is, and like you, he loves the comfort of my breasts." The look in her eyes left him dizzy and wanting more than he should. "Smart boy," Jaime concluded, not being able to turn away from his sister. As many times as he repeated that, somehow it meant nothing to him. He lowered his head and kissed her, feeling the oh-so-welcoming taste of her returning back as their only witness slept between them. Chapter